Olympic trials took place in February. Elite runners had a lot of momentum and were anxious for their chance to represent their countries on the world stage. Then the pandemic hit. Tonight, members of the 2021 U.S. Women's Olympic Marathon team relive the trials and look forward to what next year will bring.
I was very upset that morning when I got up because I got up and I felt like I had a lot of niggling pains in multiple parts of my body. And so I didn't wake up feeling excited like I usually would, you know, during a big race. And I was even more upset knowing that that was the biggest stage of my my career so far. And so I think that kind of helped me because I wasn't stressing too much about what the race was going to turn out. I was more stressed about how I was feeling. And once the gun went off, you know, I think I kind of forgot, for the most part, I forgot what was happening in my body. And I remember thinking, though, that, you know, because of the weather, I remember being super excited that, first of all, it wasn't hot because, like I was saying earlier, Marley, I don't want to run a hot marathon unless I absolutely have to do it, which I will do next summer. But I remember being super excited that it was cooler, and the fact that it was windy, I thought, well, then maybe we will have a big group for a very long time, which is exactly what happened. But really, during the race, I think I just remember, like, the second part of that race being so hilly, but then, like, feeling like, oh, I can do this, you know? And then, of course, in that last loop, sadly, I would have to say this, I'm sorry, but I remember when, right before the move happened, I remember looking ahead and seeing Molly, and then looking behind and seeing you, and then no one else behind her was like, oh, my God, this is it, like, this is happening. And I should have said, come on, Sally, but I was like, no, I'm just going to go with Molly. I mean, it sounds very mean to say that right now. But, like, I think that when that move happened, I don't even remember. Like, I don't know if any of you remembers how the move happened, but I don't. But I just remember thinking, like, oh, my God, this is actually happening. Like, I can't believe this.
Like, there were so many things for me to be nervous about before that race. Not only the sense that it was just so competitive with pretty much every pro woman that I knew and really respected was going to be on the line that day. And then just the fact that it was the first time I ever raced the marathon. So going into it, I'd almost just kind of like resigned myself to the fact of like, I was so nervous, but I was like, you know what? It's just going to be what it's going to be. Like, you have no idea what to expect. It was crazy then because the gun went off and I was able to get up to the front and like, I just felt like I was like supposed to be up there, even though like arguably I had no place putting my nose up there in it. And then kind of like what Alphine was saying with that move, I don't even know if it was mile 19 or whatnot, but on my part, it wasn't any conscious move. We were just going up a little hill and I just kept like, I don't know, I was feeling so good and so strong. And the entire pack slowed a little bit with the hill. And I just kind of kept going my same pace because I was like, I don't know. I just kind of want to like, this feels good. I don't want to have to slow down. Truthfully, it was the fact that Alphine it was within like 10 meters or so. All of a sudden I had Alphine right next to me. And it was that having Alphine there of being like, okay, this is what you're supposed to do. Like Alphine's going with you. This is someone, you know, this is someone like you've run with before. And like, she's gonna help you with this. It was just such a cool day. Like I don't think I could have like imagined it better in my mind beforehand.
Going into that race, I kind of had an idea that it was going to be a tough day, a tough competition, just based on who was there. But I think I also underestimated how difficult the course was going to be. And so the last bit of that race, when the girls are talking about the move, I wasn't caught off guard with that move. But I think it was so sudden and so sharp, I felt like that it kind of threw me off just a bit, 1 second off. And I realized, okay, this move is really quick. And I feel like if I go with these girls, I might not make it to the finish line. So I kind of made a judgment call to hold back and kind of go with my pace. And so I let them go. And I felt like that was a really good move on my part. And Those last miles, oh my God, oh my God, that was painful. I don't know how everyone else felt, but I remember those last miles being so brutal. I can't believe we were running 6 minute miles. It felt like I was running 12 minutes a mile. I was basically counting steps. And there were so many people on the course that were shouting, and they were telling me how far back that the chess group was. Everybody was shouting the seconds, 8 seconds, 12 seconds, 15 seconds. It was amazing. It's just amazing what people can come through for you. I don't even know who they were. They were just fans on the road.
I didn't realize at the time, you know, that Sally and I were going to be the first, you know, African-American women representing, you know, America in the Olympic trials for the marathon, you know, like the first Black women representing America on the marathon. And so I've gotten a lot of, you know, like letters, people saying that I inspired them. And I don't think I realized the weight of that at the time until, you know, later on, especially when, you know, things happened with George Floyd and all that stuff. And I've taken that time to really be grateful for the opportunities that I've gotten, and also realize that there's so many Black boys and girls looking at us and thinking that could be me someday. And I don't know, I just feel so grateful that we get to be those people.